2-1. Here's the wind and the 2-1 pitch. Fouled back and it's 2-2. So Chavez at third with a pop fly double. Bracketed by ground ball outs here in the top of the third. 2 balls and 2 strikes to Ondina. Snavely into the wind and the pitch. Swing and a foul back. Pitch upstairs and Ondina tried to get on top of it. Fouled it back to the net. Still 2 balls and 2 strikes. 2 outs. Chavez down the line at third. Here comes the 2-2 again. And he had him reaching and lunging a little out in front of the pitch that he fouled off again. Ondina is up there to swing. He has only walked 2 times this year. Two balls, 2 strikes, and again the pitch. Popped him up left side. We'll see if it stays in play. Wallace over for a look, and out of our view, apparently he made the catch beyond the dugout. So Wallace hauls it in and bailed out Jack Segris to a degree, stranding Chavez at third base. So a long battle won by Preston Snavely in the third. The end of 2.5, we're still scoreless from Melching Field.
At American Family Insurance, we know your life has many moving parts, from your four wheels to your hard-earned home and the financial future of your family. We'll cover the things that matter most. Bundle your home and auto policies for possible savings and add life insurance for convenient, future-focused protection so you can keep dreaming towards what's next. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, SI and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
There's too many people that get their news from, like, YouTube and TikTok.
More than ever, you need up-to-date information you can trust.
I want to make sure I'm getting the most correct information available.
Trusted news updates.
Because it is real, it is honest.
I can hear more truths.
At the top of every hour.
They do a good job of, you know, just keeping you up-to-date every hour.
They know what they're doing. They have the experts.
The news talk sports leader.
It's just a constant need for information.
This is 98.7 and 1330 KNSS.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Vivian Adams, Sean Chapman, Kerry Mock, or Chris Post. In El Dorado, see Becky Shum.
The official voice of Wichita State Baseball is 97.5 and 1240 KFH, Wichita's number one sports radio.
No score, bottom three. Shane Dennis back at Melching Field, Conrad Park, DeLand, Florida. Dave Wilson back in our Wichita studios. Shocker fans, join us every Monday night for the Eric Wedge Coaches Show at AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, 13th and Greenwich Road, live right here on KFH 97.5, 1240. AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, the home of all Shocker Coaches Shows. Cooper Harris, David Van Voren, then back to the top of the order in Jack Segrist. Each team with a hit. Shocker's got 2 aboard with 1 away in the second, but Gibson hitting into a 4-6-3 to end the threat. Cooper Harris, 1 out of 8. The hit was a home run, getting his third start behind the plate. Takes low and outside from Tyler Myrick. 1 ball and no strikes. Again, a full slate of games in the American and every conference for that matter. We'll take a look at the American Athletic Conference and a peek at Conference USA. What's going on there? That one's hit high in the air to left field. Got under it just a touch. Underneath it is Juan Teixeira and makes the catch. So Harris tested Juan Teixeira in left and tested the conditions as the wind blowing out just a little bit, but didn't get enough barrel on it. Harris is the first out. That'll bring up David Van Voren. David, 8 out of 31, 6 runs batted in. Myrick kicks and deals. Swing and a miss. Pitch down, nothing in one. So Van Voren starting for the 9th time in 13 games. He and Seth Stroh kind of rotated in and out in the center field for the Shockers this year. He takes upstairs. Van Voren does. It's 1-1. And in an effort for Wichita State to get a more optimal lineup, I suppose you could say, Van Voren crowded, 2-1. Good pitch on the inside part of the plate, just off the edge. Segrist playing short for the first time this year. Elliott playing second for the first time this year. That one bounces in there. It's 3-1. Nobody on, one out, bottom of the third. Chopper left side, charging hard as Girardi. Fields throws and safe at first. Van Voren can scoot, and there wasn't much Dante Girardi could have done differently about that little chopper. And so for the second inning in a row, the Shockers have a one-out base runner. So Van Voren legs one out. And back to the top of the order in Jack Segrist, who flied out to center to start the bottom of the first. Tyler Myrick, in his first four starts, had gone just shy of 22 innings. So he's done a good job of consistently pitching deep into ball games to start 2021. And a great block by the catcher Chavez on a pitch that bounced in front of the plate. One ball and no strikes. So far, FIU trying to kind of put it all together for a stretch of games. They've made 24 errors in 14 games, throw to first and runner back. Their bullpen has kind of faltered along the way, partly leading to that 6.53 team ERA. Kind of gone in fits and starts in their first 14 games. There goes Van Voren. The pitch is outside, and the throw down skips and gets away from the shortstop. It'll be a stolen base. Ondina tried to play the short hop, and it kicked off the tip of his glove. So Van Voren swipes second, and he's a base runner in scoring position now with one out for Segrist, who's ahead in the count 2-0. 20th steal for Wichita State this year. Van Voren second. Here's a stretch. Myrick turns and picks to the second baseman, Cartaya. And he had one bounce off of his glove. So Van Voren at second, representing the game's first run. We're in the bottom of the third inning. 2-0 in there for a strike. Eased one in there on the outside part of the dish. 2-1 to Segrist, who came in hitting 277. Plenty of room on the right side as the second baseman, Cartaya, dancing behind the bag, and a little foul tip behind home plate off the bat of Segrist. Evens the count at 2-2. Liam Eddy will pitch for Wichita State later on tonight against Stetson. Again, Stephen Casey will pitch next for FIU, but that'll come on Saturday. Here's a stretch by Myrick. 3-1, belted into the gap in left center field. It's going to drop, a base hit. Mike Sirianni's going to wave in David Van Voren. The throw is cut off. The throw down to second, and out at second is Jack Segrist. So Van Voren scores. Segrist with an RBI single, but outstretching it. And Wichita State leads it 1-0.
Now batting for the Shockers, number 3, second baseman.
Teixeira, the left fielder, did a good job to get over and cut it off. And Figueroa, the first baseman, cut off the throw to the plate when he saw that Segrist right in front of him was trying to take second base. So an infield single and a stolen base turns into the first run. There's Cooper Elliott, and he skies one. Left side, foul ground, and that's going to be out of play. Chavez and Girardi over for a look. That may have been actually Girardi the third baseman that cut that ball off. So that went 7-5-6. 7-5-4 on the putout. Little cue ball foul off the end of the bat of Cooper Elliott. And it's nothing and two. So 1-0 Wichita State. Segrist with RBI number 4. Nothing and two to Cooper Elliott. Base is empty. 0-2. Got him looking on the inside corner, and Cooper knew it. So the Shockers are done, but they score the game's first run. Two hits, nobody left. At the end of three, our new score now is the Shockers 1, Panthers nothing.
In sports, if you think joy only happens after you win, think again. Look at the world's most successful athletes like Serena Williams, Brooks Koepka, and Alex Morgan. They don't spend all their days grinding away. They take time to enjoy themselves, like getting together with friends over a Michelob Ultra, because they know that happiness is the key to winning and that joy is the whole game, not just the end game. Michelob Ultra. 95 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs. It's only worth it if you enjoy it. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, 13th and Greenwich Road in Wichita, is your new home for Shocker Coaches shows. Be sure to check out our all-new burger menu, because Mondays are burger days at AJ's. And don't forget, Thursdays are buy one, get one free pizza day. Dine in only and excludes the Superdome. Join us for happy hour every day from 2 to 6 p.m. and 9 to 11 p.m. While you're here, ride the go-karts, take a turn in the laser maze, enjoy the game room, or bowl a couple games. AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, home of the Superdome 29-inch pizza. Two locations in Wichita and one in Hutchinson. Proud supporter of Shocker Athletics.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Brad Woody, Ryan Woods, or Angela Valentine. In Derby, see Gene Geringer. And in Newton, see Ken Hall.
This is KFH.
Top of the fourth inning here from DeLand, Florida. Melching Field, Conrad Park. 23rd year of baseball at this facility here in DeLand. Generally reserved for Stetson University. Shockers and FIU. Wichita State leading this afternoon after the first third of the game, 1-0. Preston Snavely's first pitch of the fourth is high and outside. 1 ball and no strikes. Alex Sanchez hit one off of Snavely that deflected to the second baseman, Cooper Elliott. His first time up there, started to swing, held up, and took a strike, so it's 1-1. Sanchez, Juan Teixeira, and Farmer due up here in the Panther fourth. Way high and outside. 2 balls and a strike. So far for Preston Snavely, so good. First three innings took him only 33 pitches. Foul back over the roof, 2-2. Beautiful day for baseball here in DeLand. Not a cloud in the sky. Mostly cloudy here yesterday, the Shockers' workout day. FIU arrived a little later on in the afternoon here in DeLand. Way high and outside, an off-speed pitch. Curveball didn't curve much. So the first 3-ball count served up by Snavely. Here comes the payoff to Sanchez. Foul back again into the net. Three balls, two strikes, nobody on, nobody out. Top half of the fourth inning. Hit hard on the ground, but right at Cooper Elliott. And he guns to first. Sanchez out number one. There's Juan Teixeira. He fouled out right in front of his own dugout, hauled in by the Shocker first baseman, Garrett Kosas. So the Shockers will be the team that plays two today. Stetson will be the one to play two tomorrow, and FIU will play two on Sunday. Good pitch on the outside corner has Teixeira questioning himself. Teixeira, one of two Teixeiras on the team. His brother JJ is a pitcher. Started to swing on a pitch down in the dirt, blocked by Harris, but didn't look like Juan went. They're going to check, and no, he didn't. One ball, one strike. Base is empty, one out. Top of the fourth. Shockers one, Panthers nothing. Big right-hander Preston Snavely goes into the wind, and he kicks and pitches. Hit hard and up the middle for a base hit. Pass Segrist. And that's the second hit of the day for FIU.
Stepping up to the plate, number 38, right field.
And here comes Justin Farmer. Farmer grounded out to Paxton Wallace to start the second inning. So that's the second hit. And I was going to say, after FIU got its second hit, that the hit that was up there in the third, that's the type of situation, if things go great for Snavely and Wichita State, for example, and that is to say that is the only hit as we get later in the game, you might have seen it change to an error. High fly ball in the right field. Gibson waiting for it to come down, one hands it, and Farmer is out number two.
Now that is number 26, first baseman. Adrian
now Figueroa.
Figueroa.
And I say that because the Chavez pop-up should have been caught. It was overrun by Wichita State shortstop Jack Segrist, ruled the double, but we'll see if it stays that way now that Teixeira got a legitimate hit up the middle. Figueroa takes high and outside. Adrian Figueroa struck out in the second inning. 1-0 Wichita State, two outs, runner at first, top of the fourth. Teixeira, one out of two in base stealing, doesn't have much of a lead. Good pitch, but missed. 2-0. That was the first questionable pitch that didn't go to the pitcher by home plate umpire John Bennett. Cooper Harris was asking him where that pitch was. 2-0 to Figueroa. Had him reaching. He golfs one foul back and just to our left into the bleachers. 2-1. So good pitcher's pitch on 2-0. Teixeira at first base, two away in the Panther fourth inning. Figueroa still has the count his way, 2-1. Long holding the stretch. Snavely brings it home and hits sharply and into left field for a base hit. So one to Segrist left, one to his right. Teixeira's going to go to third base on the single by Figueroa.
Not batting for the Panthers, number five, second baseman, Derek.
So now Derek Cartaya, he grounded to Wallace at third, his last time up there. So FIU threatening here in the top of the fourth, 1-0 Wichita State. Snavely has runners at the corners. Hits are now even at three apiece. Cartaya waiting. Snavely's ready. The pitch. He bunts up along first. Fielded by Kosas. He's going to have to tag him coming by, and he does. Boy, that was a do-or-die play by Kosas. Nobody else was over there. And Cartaya tried to avoid the tag. Went toward the first base dugout as far as he could, but Kosas reached out and swiped him. Three unassisted, and that's that. We'll go to the bottom of the fourth. Still the Shockers one. Panthers nothing.
Are the front wheels of your outfit shakier than cafeteria Jell-O? Yep, these wintertime ruts and potholes can take their toll on your car or pickup. But the folks at Kansas Land Tire can smooth things out for you. These folks understand the front end of your car. Well, come to think of it, they understand everything about your outfit from tires to tail lights. Your vehicles couldn't be in better hands than Kansas Land Tire. Find the shop nearest you by going online at kansaslandtire.com. And remember, if you're out of air or need repair, these guys care.
Cy Mock, President CEO from Chisholm Trail State Bank for Sendio.
We're a local bank. We looked at hiring an HR specialist and compared that to outsourcing the HR function. For us, the decision was very clear. We chose Sendio. The advice I would give another organization that's looking to outsource is do your due diligence, Look at what they bring to the table. And I think you will find that Syndio has the full gamut to support your organization.
Call Syndio today, 316-630-9107.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Sandra Means or John Green. In Mulvane, see Kirk Farber. And in Andover, see Wes Sawyer.
This is your home for sports. 97.5 and 1240 KFH.
3, 4, and 5 in the order for Wichita State. Bottom of the fourth. Shockers out in front of FIU, 1-0. Hits are even at 3 apiece. B. Paxton Wallace, Garrett Kosis, Corrigan Bartlett facing Tyler Myrick. Myrick was touched for an RBI single in the last inning. And Wallace started to swing, held up and took a strike. Here's the wind in the 0-1. Swung on and missed, a slider down the dirt. Nothing in two to Paxton Wallace. O-2. Outside. 1-2. Wallace didn't play at all last year with a bad back. It was a pretty mysterious back ailment. Popped up foul right side, not a play. It was really for a long time, as long as 15-game stint can be, a long time that Wallace was just day-to-day. Show up at the ballpark and find out if he was well enough to play, and he never really was. Fully healthy now. 9 home runs a couple of years ago. And he tomahawks one into right field for a base hit. Pitch was up and out over the plate, and Wallace served it into right for a hit. So a leadoff base runner for the first time in the game.
Now batting, number 29, first baseman,
Garrett Kosis grounded out to first base unassisted. First time up there. So one on, nobody out in the bottom of the fourth. Shockers 1, Panthers nothing. First ever meeting between the two teams. A swing and a foul back by Garrett Kosis. Had a good rip at one. Shockers have only played Stetson once in the program's history. Wallace back to first after time was called by somebody. Myrick has to reload here. Now comes set. Runner not going. The pitch is a strike on the inside part of the plate. Kosis was giving ground. 0-2 to Garrett Kosis. Had back-to-back 2 home run games already this season. Way high with a fastball. That one 94. So Myrick reached back for a little extra on 0-2, but never intended to be a strike. 1-2. Scoreboard had a little catching up to do. 1 run, 4 hits for the Shockers. 0 runs, 3 hits for the Panthers. Way high and outside. Same pitch, same result. That one at 94 as well. Wind continues to drift ever so slightly out to center and right center. Change directions just a touch. Blowing more out to left center a couple innings ago. 2-2 to Kosis. Myrick wants to make it happen right here. And he steps off the rubber. And he balked. Or did he call timeout? I beg your pardon. The third base umpire, Robert Nunez, just signaling that the pitcher is the one that broke contact. So Wallace still at first. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Myrick's ready. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Threw it past him. And down goes Kosis.
Now batting number 34, left fielder, Corrigan.
Strikeout number number two, for Myrick. And that's 2 in the last 3 batters that he's faced. Corrigan Bartlett didn't see a strike his first time up there. So now Bartlett has reached base safely in every game this year. And that's ball in the dirt. It's going to be a wild pitch. Chavez did everything he could to block it. He technically did, but it bounced out in front of home plate, and Wallace with a decent read, although he could have walked to second base. A wild pitch charged to Tyler Myrick. Only a third wild pitch that he's uncorked this year. Runner in scoring position. Now they're just going to intentionally pass Corrigan Bartlett. So they're not going to mess with him. Shocker's leading hitter that will leave it up to Cooper Kornblum, who had a little swinging bunt single his first time up there. So that sets up a double play. It'll be right-hander against right-hander. Myrick and Kornblum. 1-0 Shockers, bottom four. Here's a stretch. Myrick checks the runner at second base and delivers outside. Slider just off the plate, 1-0. Two on, one out. 1-0 to Kornblum. Had him reaching, he fouled it back to the net. One ball and one strike. Later on tonight for Wichita State, as I mentioned, Liam Eddy will pitch for the Shockers. Tomorrow, Stephen Casey and Josh Plummer will be the combatants on the mound for FIU and Stetson. 1-1 to Kornblum. Swung on and he missed. Slider that he was out in front of just enough. 1-2. Hunter Gibson would be next. Myrick ahead in the count to Kornblum, but he just uncorked a wild pitch, and now the shortstop jumps in behind the runner. Second pitch home is fouled back. Ondina playing games with Wallace out there at second base. And Myrick actually delivered home probably a little quicker than he should have, because Ondina wasn't exactly in his ordinary spot. He was playing cat and mouse with Wallace. Count holding at 1-2. Hit hard right at the shortstop on one hop. A 6-4-3 double play. Cooper Kornblum hit it hard, but FIU has turned in the second twin killing in the first half of the game. So 6-4-3 and out, and the Shockers leave a runner. At the end of four, it is still Wichita State 1, FIU nothing.
It's time to go inside the numbers with BKD, CPAs, and advisors. BKD has proudly served the Midwest for more than 90 years. Your team values excellence as much as ours, and we're your biggest fans. As you look toward continued growth and profitability, BKD has the bench strength and resources to help you develop a winning strategy. Everyone needs a trusted advisor. Who's yours? Go to BKD.com and go Shocks.
98.7 and 1330 KNSS has been recognized by the Kansas Association of Broadcasters as having the best large market radio website. Find out why. News, information, listen live. Visit us daily at KNSSradio.com. Wichita's number one talk.
97.5 and 1240 KFH. K248CY Wichita. KNSS HC2 Clearwater. A radio.com sports station.
1-0 Wichita State heading to inning number 5 here in DeLand. Shocker Sports Properties and Wichita State Athletics would like to thank the Shocker Ambassadors, Wichita State's elite level of corporate partners, Ascension Via Christi, House of Schwann, Delta Dental, Koch Industries, Kansas Star Casino, and Cox Communications. If you're interested in becoming a corporate partner of Wichita State Athletics, call Shocker Sports Properties at 316-978-7552. Ben Rosenblum lead it off here to start the fifth inning for FIU. 1-4-0 for Wichita State, 0-3-0 for FIU. Rosenblum grounded out his first time up. Takes a knee-high strike and runs away here in the fifth. Snavely, 5 innings, 3 hits. Or 4 innings, rather. Gave him one extra. Four innings pitched so far. That one's hit high in the air to center field and fairly deep, but Van Voren's got plenty of room out there, and he makes the catch. So Rosenblum picked on the deepest part of the park and is out number one.
Now batting number nine, the catcher.
So now Snavely, four and a third, three hits, no walks, two strikeouts. Myrick, four innings, four hits, one run, two walks, two strikeouts. Neither pitcher has had to work very hard. Luis Chavez hit a pop fly double his first time up there. And he hits one on the ground to the backhand side. Wallace, nice play. Guns across and plenty of time. Just a grass hugger ground ball between Wallace and the third base bag, but Wallace got a good break on it. And he takes care of Luis Chavez. Here's Dante Girardi. Grounded to short his first time up there. Girardi is one of three sons of former big leaguers on this FIU roster. And not a spare part in the bunch as far as the dads are concerned. Of course, former All-Star, three-time World Series champion, and current Phillies manager Joe Girardi is Dante's dad. Strike called. But also, this FIU roster features R.J. Ibanez, son of former Royal, and many others, Raul Ibanez. Just a little bit low. Good pitch. One ball and one strike to Dante Girardi. And finally, El Duque's kid, Orlando Hernandez, is on this club as well. Three-time world champion and ALCS MVP, Orlando Hernandez. Strike in there, and Girardi has taken three, two of them called strikes. Base is empty, two outs. Panther fifth. And Dante Girardi is all over home plate. Here is the 1-2. And a little looper right side. Elliott, the second baseman, out calling, catching, and that's that. So Preston Snavely has a very economical fifth inning. We are halfway through from Melching Field in DeLand. It's Wichita State 1, FIU nothing.
We had building and space limitations that required us to build and to take a loan, and that's where we met CAFET.
They were one of the few banks that believed in us.
It's not just a bank, it's the people. I can pick a phone up and call somebody and get an answer right away.
They're always there to support us.
They have a lot of resources, and those people know what they're doing.
Their insight as well as their heart to help has always been such a joy to work with.
Capital Federal is business ready with commercial lending for your business. Visit CAPFED.com/business ready. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Hey, Shocker fans! Ready for a new and exciting golf membership? Join the club where Shocker fans and staff play. When you join Great Life, you have two beautiful golf courses to choose from: Tallgrass Country Club and Willow Bend Golf Club. Experience our warm and inviting country club atmosphere. Perfect your skills at our excellent practice facilities, all included with that one membership. Enjoy the best golfing value in Wichita at one of our courses and spend more time on the fairway with Great Life.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Michael Rogers or Dusty Self. In Augusta, see Dylan Hartnett. And in Valley Center, see Tim Dink.
Sports Radio KFH.
Got a defensive change for Florida International. They have a new right fielder in the ballgame. But he's far enough out there and with a black uniform on and blue numbers. Hard to tell exactly who it is, but we'll update you as soon as it pops up on the live stats. So apparently something happened to Justin Farmer. Lower third of the order for Wichita State in the fifth. Hunter Gibson to lead things off. Gibson grounded into one of two double plays hit into by the Shockers today. And Tyler Myrick's first pitch to him. Popped up, foul, back and out of play. One One run, four hits for Wichita State. No runs, three hits for FIU. Fastball is upstairs. Shocker's got the only run of the game in the third inning. RBI single for Jack Seeger scored David Van Vorn. A little bit high. Myrick came in on, or tried to come in on, Hunter Gibson. Halfway through the first of two for the Shockers today. Chopping ground ball, and Easton Herring clangs it with his left bare hand. Volunteer assistant over at first. Base is empty, nobody out. Bottom half of the fifth inning. A little bit high. So three balls and two strikes. Gibson starting the bottom of the fifth. Pitch to him is hit high in the air to shallow left. Over goes the shortstop, the only guy on that side of the diamond, and he makes the catch. It was Ondina. And actually, there have been a couple of defensive changes. So Gibson pops out to the shortstop. I think that one in right field is the only one. Again, we'll keep you up to date if there were any players moving around in addition to straight substitutions. One out, and Harris, Shocker catcher, takes a strike on the outer edge. Harris flied to left his first time. Cooper Harris now one out of nine, cuts and misses at an off-speed pitch down, and it's quickly 0-2. Oh and two to the Shocker catcher. Myrick back to work. And he bounces one in there. I think that's Sean Kennedy in right field, replacing Justin Farmer. Farmer didn't bat last inning, so it wasn't something that happened, at least to him when he was at the plate. Little squibber to the first baseman, Figueroa. A lot of English on it, but he takes it himself. Two outs now here in the Shocker fifth.
Stepping up to the plate, number 14, center fielder.
Now David Van Vorn, he scored the game's only run. Van Vorn back in the third inning, singled, stole second, and then Segrist knocked him in with a base hit to left center. Base is empty, two outs. Here's the wind, and Myrick's pitch bounces and blocked by Chavez. Boy, Luis Chavez can really block back there. He's been tested. There has been a wild pitch thrown by Myrick, but it was hardly Luis Chavez's deal. Half swing, and he went too far. Van Vorn on the pitch away from him. So Myrick and Snavely in a pitcher's duel here at Melching Field. Chopper to the shortstop. Ondina backs up to get the hop and safe at first. Boy, he hesitated, and he decided pretty much right away, I'm going to lay back and wait for that next hop, and it burned him, at least for the moment. I say that because Merville Melendez, head coach, is going to have a word with the first base umpire. That's Ray Chamberlain. So Van Vorn now with a couple of infield hits. Segrist, Shocker leadoff man, has been announced. And that's the end of the argument. It wasn't much of one anyway, but here's Jack Segrist, one out of two. We'll see if Van Voren takes off during the course of this plate appearance. One nothing Shockers. Runner at first, two away, bottom of the fifth. Runner not going on the first pitch. Pitch is a strike. Picked back to first by the catcher Chavez. And backstanding is David Van Voren. Segrist fly ball center field, RBI single. Shockers have out hit the Panthers now 5-3. All their hits have been singles. Low and outside to Segrist. One ball and one strike. Only run of the game came in the third. Runner goes, pitch is high. The throw down is glancing off of Van Voren. It's going to go into left field. He's around third, and they're going to wave him in. Here comes the play at the plate. A great throw from the left fielder out at home plate. Juan Teixeira gunned down. David Van Voren trying to score all the way from, as it turned out, first base. So a stolen base, E2, and 7-2 as Teixeira threw a bullet to home plate to cut down Van Voren. At the end of five, it's still 1-0 Wichita State.
Litton's Appliance would like to thank all their loyal customers for their support as we struggle through these tough times. If you are in need of a new appliance, Litton's will work hard, as always, to get you what you need at a price no more than the big box guys. If we don't have what you need in stock, we will help you out with a loaner when available to get you by until your order can be delivered. Come by, call, or visit our website today to make your selection from the many quality brands we sell like Whirlpool, Maytag, and KitchenAid. Litton's Appliance, where you'll always get the right product at the right price.
Growing up, my parents always encouraged me to do what's right, even if it wasn't easy. I'd always hear my mother's voice say, "Do the right thing." That stuck with me. Every day, just do the right thing. That's it. The rest takes care of itself.
At Shelter Insurance, we believe in doing the right thing for our customers and our communities.
See Mike Renner in Wichita, Josh Alexander in McPherson, or Doug Heary in Marion.
The official voice of Wichita State Baseball is 97.5 and 1240 KFH, Wichita's number one sports radio.
Well, David Van Voren, after a stolen base and the ball ricocheting off his person into left field, tried to score, and it really took a perfect throw from Juan Teixeira to cut him down, and that's what happened. Teixeira to the catcher Chavez to keep this game 1-0. Trying to bunny his way on is Ondina, the leadoff man, and it's 0-1. Fouls one toward the first base dugout. One run, five hits, no errors for Wichita State. No runs, three hits, and that throwing error by the catcher Chavez on the stolen base. Ondina, Sanchez, and Teixeira here in inning number six. Slow stuff, popped up, foul, back and out of play. It's going to make it into the crowd. Now down into the lower box where the players and scouts are sitting. Sunsplash day here at Melching Field in DeLand. 72 degrees, not a cloud in the sky. Snavely working on a gem, brings in the 0-2. Started to swing and held up on slow stuff down. One ball and two strikes. Ondina is struck out and popped to the third baseman, Paxton Wallace, right in front of the barrier. 1-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Ondina down on strikes for the second time.
Now batting number four, center fielder, Alec Sanchez.
That'll bring up Sanchez. He is grounded out twice. Into the full windup. First pitch to him is a little high. Alex Sanchez lined one off of the arm of Preston Snavely, and then Cooper Elliott gathered it in, so it went 1-4-3. That one's a strike. And then a more conventional ground ball to Elliott in the fourth. Ball and a strike to Alex Sanchez, the FIU center fielder. Snavely's Snavely threw him a slow curveball that finds a strike zone, 67 miles an hour. Big Uncle Charlie dropped in there, and it's 1-2. Here comes the 1-2 pitch. Same pitch that went into the dirt, and good job by Sanchez, who flinched but didn't go. 2 balls and 2 strikes. Base is empty, 1 out in the FIU 6th. Snavely couldn't get together with Cooper Harris, and Alec Sanchez got tired of waiting, stepped out. Now here's the 2-2. Popped up right behind home plate, and Harris looking for room but runs out of it. Again, not a whole lot of foul ground here at Melching Field. Around home plate is where there's the most of it. Pretty much from dugout to dugout, there's some room, but not much else. Still 2-2 to Sanchez. Snavely's pitch. Chopping ground ball foul in between Kosas and the first base coaching box. The only scoring came in the third. David Van Vorn, infield hit, stolen base. Jack Segrist, RBI single. And that one bounces in front of home plate. Now it's 3-2. Shockers have had base runners in each of the last 4 innings. There's only been a couple of innings where FIU has had a base runner. Strike three called on the outside corner. Sanchez thought it was ball four, and he is the second strikeout victim of the inning. One swinging, one looking. Now Juan Teixeira, the reason this game is still 1-0. Teixeira fouled out the first, singled with one out in the fourth. There are 2 outs here in the sixth. Snavely's ready. The first pitch is popped up, right side and playable. Kosas called off by Elliott. Out number three. 3 up and 3 down for Preston Snavely, who has turned in 6 scoreless innings here in DeLand. Go to the bottom of the sixth. It's still the Shockers 1 and the Panthers nothing.
Life is full of curveballs. Your bank should not be one of them. That's why your team at Equity Bank is always on deck, ready to step up to the plate and deliver more. With more response, more attention, and more expertise, we're here to help you succeed in all of life's innings. When it comes to banking, equity means more. That's a home run. Go to equitybank.com/more for details. Member FDIC.
When two teams compete on the court, there can only be one winner. But in business and life, Koch Industries believes that win-win outcomes are the key to long-term success. That's why Koch creates innovations to meet everyday needs like cleaner water, renewable fuels, advanced medical devices, safer vehicles, and energy-efficient building materials. See the inspiring stories for yourself at kochindustries.com.
This is KFH.
Bottom half of the Shockers 6. It's 1-0 Wichita State. And Tyler Myrick out for inning number 6 for FIU. He's been good today. Myrick, so far, through 5 innings, scattered 5 singles, 2 walks, 2 strikeouts. Got some help from his left fielder, Juan Teixeira, in the last half inning to keep this a 1-0 game. Top of the order for Wichita State. Segrist, Elliott, and Wallace have combined to go 2-for-6 so far in the game. Third time through the order. And Segrist cuts and misses at a slider. We're underway here in the bottom of the sixth. Shane Dennis here at the ballpark. Dave Wilson back in our Wichita studios. Glad to bring you FIU and Wichita State for the first time ever on the ball diamond. High strike, and it's 0-2. Segrist out of the box for a moment. Maybe had something to say to John Bennett, the home plate umpire. Bennett's had an easy time of it. These two pitchers have been filling up the strike zone. Popped up right side, might be trouble. Shallow right field, a long run for the second baseman, and Cartaya makes a sliding catch. Cartaya was the only one going to get that one, and get it he did. Over the shoulder sliding catch for out number one. That would have been a pop fly double for Segrist, but Cartaya robs him, and there's one out. That'll bring up Cooper Elliott. Elliott hitless in two trips. Cooper is starting the game at second base for the first time this year. Takes a strike. Elliott can play about any position on the diamond, maybe except for pitcher, and that includes catching. He can catch if necessary. A little topper foul. No balls and two strikes. So Tyler Myrick came into the game with a rather elevated 4.98 ERA, but that's the situation when you have one bad outing in your first four. You can muddy up your season numbers, but he's taken care of that so far today. That one's fouled back by Elliott. He had a good swing. These two teams will meet at 11:30 Sunday morning here local time. That straightened up Elliott, a fastball underneath his hands, 1-2. And now Dante Girardi, the third baseman, is going to go into a shift. He's going to play basically second base, and Cartaya is going to play in short right field. And a little popper foul by Elliott, turned on one and pulled it past the bleachers. So three infielders on the right side of the diamond. And Elliott's going to have a hard time getting the base hit to right field. The shortstop on Dina is playing shortstop, so there's all kind of real estate to his right. Swinging a foul tip, and Cooper Elliott stays alive. Part of it has to do with what the FIU coaching staff thinks Elliott is going to do, but I'm sure an even bigger part of it has to do with Tyler Myrick and how he's going to pitch Cooper Elliott. And that one's sprayed to the left side, over toward the line, and Teixeira makes a running catch. He actually had to reach back for it after getting close to the foul line. So Elliott flies to left. There are two away in the Shocker six. Paxton Wallace has singled in two trips. Steered one into right field in the fourth. FIU has turned two double plays also to keep this thing 1-0. Swing and a miss, and a pitch down from Tyler Myrick. One nothing Wichita State. Only run of the game in the third. Low and outside, a slider to Wallace. If Wallace reaches, Garrett Kosas would be next. Swing and a miss. Slider down, 1-2. When Myrick and Preston Snavely have put on a show. 1-2 pitch. Over but low. He threw him another hard slider. Cutter, 87. 2-2. Two outs. Base is empty in the Shocker sixth. Shockers home team for the only time this weekend. Down and in, tried another one, and it's three balls and two strikes. Three balls, two strikes, nobody on, two outs. Into the full windup. Myrick brings it home, and a swing and a miss, and down goes Wallace. Three up and three down in the Shocker six. We'll go to the seventh. It's still Wichita State 1, FIU nothing.
No matter what pops up during your day, Ascension Via Christi, the exclusive healthcare provider of Shocker Athletics, makes it easy to get the care you need at any time from anywhere. Now you can see a doctor online, right from home, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Check in online for immediate care. Find ER care near you, or you can even schedule a visit with a primary care doctor. You'll find it all at GetViaChristiCare.com. That's GetViaChristiCare.com. With locations across Kansas, Ascension Via Christi, proud partners of Shocker Athletics.
When you're ready to retire, do it with a dental plan that gives you the smile power to make your golden years sparkle. When you're 10 minutes late for the breakfast menu and the server isn't a morning person. When your highfalutin son-in-law has grilling suggestions that are all hot air. You need an affordable and high-quality dental insurance plan to protect your healthy smile so you can unleash your smile power. Unleash your smile power with Delta Dental of Kansas.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Vivian Adams, Sean Chapman, Kerry Mock, or Chris Post. In El Dorado, see Becky Shum.
This is your home for sports. 97.5 and 1240 KFH.
Defensive change for Wichita State as we play here in the top of the seventh. Andrew Stewart is going to play shortstop now. Segrist moves from short to second. And batting for the first time against Preston Snavely is Seth Kennedy. Came into the game defensively a couple innings ago. Seth Kennedy is 4-for-17. He's up there from the right side, and he takes low and away from Preston Snavely. It's one ball and no strikes. 1-0, Wichita State in the seventh. Snavely to Kennedy. Strike in there. Snavely, 6 innings, 3 hits, no walks, 4 strikeouts. That was his 71st pitch. Hammered into center field. Van Vorn coming in a hurry, and did he make the catch? No signal from anybody, and now the first base umpire said, yeah, he caught it. Yeah, the first base umpire made the call. And I think it was a right one. It was just a late one and an awkward two-knee slide by Van Vorn. He kind of made a basket catch right off the top of the grass. And now the home plate umpire, John Bennett's going to get Ray Chamberlain, who called the out from basically right at first base. And Robert Nunez, third base umpire, getting together to make sure that they're all on the same page, and they are. Out number one. So Kennedy hit a top spin lob into center field that Van Vorn battled to the death. Made a basket catch right off the top of the turf. One out, and now here's Adrian Figueroa. Figueroa, a hit in 2 trips. Up there from the left side. Takes down and in. 1 ball and no strikes. So the veteran Snavely and the rookie Cooper Harris, the battery here today. Right back through the middle, and a dive by Stewart, and he can't get it. So Figueroa has a 2-hit game, and he's a base runner with 1 out. Now Cartaya. Cartaya, 0-for-2 with a pair of groundouts. Tried to bunt his way on his last time up there with runners at first and third. And Kosas scooped it up and tagged Cartaya running by. And now the third base coach wants to talk to Cartaya and Figueroa, who has to come sprinting over from first base. Interesting dynamic watching Figueroa stand next to Cartaya. Figueroa is 6'6", Cartaya is 5'5". So a runner at first, 1 out, top of the seventh, Melching Field, Conrad Park here in DeLand, Florida. Figueroa has not attempted a steal yet this year, and with 1 out, you wouldn't figure that Cartaya would be bunting, but you never know, throw to first and runner back. Cartaya came into the game the third leading hitter on the team. Batting average coming in .295 for those that qualify. And that one's lined in the left center field. It's going to drop for a base hit. Here comes Corrigan Bartlett to cut it off. Stopping at second is Figueroa. And Cartaya pushes the tying run to second base.
Stepping up to the plate, the DH, number 10.
Now Ben Rosenblum, he's grounded to third, flied to center. Rosenblum now 6 out of 35 on the year. Mike Pelfrey, Shocker pitching coach, makes his first visit of the day to the mound. I want to remind you Shocker fans to join us every Monday night for the Eric Wedge Coaches Show. It's at AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, 13th and Greenwich Road, broadcasting live right here on KFH, 97.5 and 1240 AM. AJ Sports Grill at the Alley, the home for all Shocker coaches shows. So it looks like Pelfrey's going to stick with Snavely. Pats him on the chest a couple of times and on the rear end once, and that's that. Big Pelf going back to the third base Shocker dugout. So two on for Rosenblum. Again, a reminder, a little later on tonight, 5:30 in the Central Time Zone will be Wichita State and Stetson. Second game of the day for the Shockers. First things first. First and second, one out. Top seven. Rosenblum waits on Snavely. And it's bounced, and Cooper Harris made a great block. And that kept Figueroa at second base. So far today, Rosenblum hit a ground ball to Wallace at third and hit one to fairly deep center field. FIU has turned two double plays today. Shockers have not rolled one over yet. Pop up behind home plate. Harris tosses the mask aside, circles under it, makes the catch. Two down. Rosenblum fouls out to the catcher.
Now
Luis Chavez, the catcher.
Luis Chavez.
Chavez hit a moonshot to third that dropped untouched for a two-base hit. And then he grounded to Paxton Wallace at third base. 1-0 Wichita State. Two on, two out, and the Panther seventh. Hits are now even at five apiece after Figueroa and Cartaya's base hits here in the inning. Chavez waiting on Snavely, the pitch. Just inside, a fastball, one ball and no strikes. Chavez is hard to walk. He's only walked twice in his previous 11 starts. He's up there to swing the bat. Here's a 1-0. Rocket foul. He was way out in front of one. That was never fair. And it's now one ball and one strike. Two on, two out in the FIU seventh. The only other time that they have put two on in an inning was the fourth. That was when Cartaya tried to push bunt a run in. Snavely trying to keep it a 1-0 game. Here's the stretch. Look back at Figueroa and the pitch. Slow stuff, line drive into center field. Here comes Van Voor, and he dives, and he trapped this one. Run's going to come home and score the game's, or the FIU's first run. Van Voor almost made two circus catches in the inning, but Chavez bounced it in front of him, and Figueroa scores to make it 1-1. Stopping at second is Cartaya. And so now Dante Girardi, and he is going to face a new Shocker pitcher. Shame for Snavely, who can now no longer win it. He pitched into the seventh inning before finally surrendering a run. So we've got a pitching change. It's 1-1 with two on and two out and one in. Pitching change brought to you by Capital Federal. Trust the True Blue team at CapFed for local home loans and banking services to keep you at the top of your game. Find a location near you or open an account online at CapFed.com. Capital Federal, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC. Two on, two out in a 1-1 ball game. Tell you about the new Shocker pitcher when we come back.
We have many offices, and Capital Federal has many locations, so we can build those local relationships.
It's easy to get a hold of anybody at CapFed.
You need to look at what services they provide, what impact they have on the community, and who the people are, and CapFed checks the box on all three.
When you have a relationship with a bank that cares about the work that you're doing, then that makes it a really good relationship.
And I always recommend Capital Federal. They want the business, too, just like we do.
CapFed is business-ready with business accounts and cash management services. Visit CapFed.com/business-ready. Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
It's time to go inside the numbers with BKD CPAs and advisors. BKD has proudly served the Midwest for more than 90 years. Your team values excellence as much as ours, and we're your biggest fans. As you look toward continued growth and profitability, BKD has the bench strength and resources to help you develop a winning strategy. Everyone needs a trusted advisor. Who's yours? Go to BKD.com and go Shocks.
Sports Radio KFH.
Tommy Barnhouse now pitching for Wichita State. Preston Snavely has given up three singles here in the seventh inning. The third with two outs bringing home Adrian Figueroa with the tying run. So 1-1 ball game. First and second. Barnhouse appearing for the seventh time this year. Six innings, one run so far, 1-0 with one save. He will face Dante Girardi. In the Shocker half of the seventh, they'll have Kosis, Bartlett, and Kornblum. And we'll see if Tyler Myrick goes back out there for his seventh inning of work. Girardi is grounded to short and popped to second. One-one tie in the top of the seventh inning. Shocker run in the third. Panthers have struck here in this inning. Barnhouse steps off. Barnhouse done a little of everything in his Shocker career. Started, he's closed. This is appearance number 52. Shocker right-hander. First pitch is fouled back. Girardi jumping on the first good one that he saw, and he fouled it back to the net. FIU is now out to hit the Shocker, 6-5. There's only been one extra base hit in the game, and it didn't leave the infield. Pop fly by Chavez was ruled a double. Every other hit's been a one base hit. Girardi leaned out of the way of a breaking ball in on him, and it was ball one. Barnhouse trying to strand the go-ahead runner at second base in Cartaya. Chavez over at first. 1-1 to Girardi. Little popper, shallow right field, and that's going to drop for a base hit. Girardi just hit a parachute into right field, and it's 2-1 FIU. Girardi came in hitting 152, but he knocks in the go-ahead run, and you can charge that one to Preston Snavely. Over to third goes Chavez. Now on Dina, the second baseman, or the shortstop rather, 0-3. Boy, and now not only can Snavely not win the game, he's on the hook for the loss after pitching as well as he did for as long as he did. Still the final third of the game to go, but now FIU leads for the first time. Ondina takes a little bit high, one ball and no strikes. Mentioned the diminutive stature of Derek Cartaya at only 5'5". Ondina is only 5'8". Ondina, freshman from Puerto Rico. Leaned him back, fastball, and that's 2-0. Two balls and no strikes. FIU has taken the lead here in the seventh. That's in there for a strike. Up around the belt, 2-1. Kennedy started the inning with a sinking liner into center field that Van Voren went to both knees to corral before it hit the ground. Then Figueroa grounded one into center field. Cartaya singled to left. And after Rosenblum fouled out to the catcher, Snavely was just one pitch away from keeping this 1-0, but Chavez and now Girardi off of Barnhouse have connected with two out base hits. It's 2-1, FIU. Line drive, base hit, right field. Ondina knocks in the third run. Over to cut it off is Gibson. Heading to third is Girardi, and now it's 3-1. So it's been a death by paper cuts type of inning for Wichita State, and FIU has come to life here in the seventh with five singles. And now Alex Sanchez, the center fielder, becomes the eighth man to bat in the inning. So runners at the corners, three in the FIU seventh. Sanchez is 0-for-3. The pitch down around the feet of Sanchez. And Cooper Harris had to go to both knees to block it. Line drive right at the shortstop, Stewart. He's going to step on the bag, and the inning finally ends. But FIU comes alive offensively. Panthers get three runs on five hits, and two were left. And our new scores, the folks here in DeLand stretch, it's FIU 3, Shockers 1.
In sports, if you think joy only happens after you win, think again. Look at the world's most successful athletes like Serena Williams, Brooks Koepka, and Alex Morgan. They don't spend all their days grinding away. They take time to enjoy themselves, like getting together with friends over a Michelob Ultra, because they know that happiness is the key to winning and that joy is the whole game, not just the end game. Michelob Ultra, 95 calories, 2.6 grams of carbs. It's only worth it if you enjoy it. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Everybody's hopping on the bundle bandwagon. From your favorite apps to new tech, you can be sure there's a bundle just waiting to be bought. But there's one place that bundles news, talk, traffic, and weather 24/7, absolutely free.
More stories continue to change rapidly.
Find out when to bundle up, when to mask up, and what's happening in your world.
We need to get the whole truth.
Brighter days ahead.
On 98.7 and 1330 KNSS.
Sports Radio KFH.
Tyler Myrick pitching with the lead for the first time today. Out for inning number 7 for FIU. After the Panthers got him 3 in the top of the inning. Tyler Myrick, 6 innings, 5 hits, 1 run, 2 walks, 3 strikeouts. So he hadn't had the big strikeout totals today. But the only run he gave up came in the third inning. And Wichita State has not had more than 4 batters appear in an inning yet. Went in order in the first. There was a double play in the second. Segrist was out stretching a single to a double in the third. There was a double play in the fourth. There was an out at home plate in the fifth, the Shockers went in order in the sixth. So here's Kosas with FIU leading 3-1. High drive into deep center field. Back goes Sanchez, still going back, and gone. Home run number 8 for Garrett Kosas, and now it's 3-2. Kosas with a majestic home run, and on the first pitch of the seventh inning, the Shockers register their second run. RBI number 19 on the year for Kosas, who golfed one out of here just to the right of the batter's eye in deepest center field, right over Corey Kluber's picture, former Hatter great and Cy Young Award winner. So the Shockers strike back on one pitch, and now Corrigan Bartlett, who's walked twice. And he swings at the first pitch he sees and fouls it off of the catcher Chavez and back to the screen. So Kosas' eighth home run of the year cuts the lead to 3-2. Bartlett swings and misses at a pitch down. No balls and two strikes. Base is empty. Shockers seventh. Batting as the home team. Myrick brings it in. And he struck him out. Boy, that doesn't happen often. Bartlett went down on three pitches, and Corrigan strikes out for only the fifth time this year.
Now batting number four, the DH, Cooper Kornblum.
Cooper Kornblum has singled and grounded into a double play. Pop fly foul right side and out of play. Just a gorgeous day for baseball here in Florida. Up and away to Kornblum. One one is looped foul right side, not a play again. One ball and two strikes to Kornblum. That home run served up by Myrick was his fifth of the season. So on average, one per start. But fortunately for him, it came with the bases empty. Strike three called on the outside corner. Kornblum couldn't pull the trigger. So after the strikeout, or after the home run by Kosas, back-to-back strikeouts. And now Hunter Gibson. Gibson has hit into a double play and popped out. Three to two, FIU, bottom of the seventh inning. Bases empty. Up around the eyes of Gibson, one ball and no strikes. Gibson came into the game hitting .233. Six of his seven hits have been singled so far this year, and he fouls one back here and out of play over the roof. One ball and one strike. Tyler Myrick dueled with Preston Snavely for six innings. Strike on the outside corner. So now pitching with the lead. One strike away from getting through seven. Girardi, the third baseman, runs over to the right side of the diamond to employ the shift now with two strikes. Did it against Cooper Elliott, too. Just inside, and Myrick thought he had strike three. He walks about five paces toward his dugout. It was a pitch in on Gibson, and Gibson kind of jackknifed out of the way, maybe to sell it or maybe to prove to everybody watching that he wasn't looking for it in there. 2-2. The wind in the pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. After the Kosas home run on the first pitch of the inning, Myrick strikes out the next three. We'll go to the top of the eighth. Our new score is now FIU 3, Wichita State 2.
There's too many people that get their news from, like, YouTube and TikTok.
More than ever, you need up-to-date information you can trust.
I want to make sure I'm getting the most correct information available.
Trusted news updates.
Because it is real, it is honest.
I can hear more truths.
At the top of every hour.
They do a good job of, you know, just keeping you up-to-date every hour.
They know what they're doing. They have the experts.
The news talk sports leader.
It's just a constant need for information.
This is 98.7 and 1330 KNSS.
Hey everyone, it's CJ McCollum, host of the Pull Up Podcast. Whether it's after a tough game or practice, there's nothing better than a nice hot shower to get you feeling your best. And the crucial part of that process is the body wash you use. The new Dove Men plant-based body wash is different because it uses plant-based cleansers and moisturizers. It's clean, it's fresh, and it leaves your skin feeling healthy and hydrated. Relax your body and mind. Shower with the new Dove Men plant-based body wash.
Experience the Dove Men Plus Care plant-based line for yourself. Buy it now at Walmart and Target.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Brad Woody, Ryan Woods, or Angela Valentine. In Derby, see Gene Geringer. And in Newton, see Ken Hall.
This is KFH.
Top half of the eighth inning here at Melching Field in DeLand, Florida. FIU 3, WSU 2. 3, 4, and 5 coming up for the Panthers here in the 8th against Tommy Barnhouse. All three of the runs have now officially been charged to Preston Snavely. And it, in some ways, feels like he deserves better than that. 3 runs and 6 2/3 doesn't tell the story. Barnhouse delivers a strike to Juan Teixeira. 3 runs, 8 hits, and 1 error for FIU. 2 runs, 6 hits, no errors for Wichita State. Teixeira is singled in 3 at-bats. Same pitch, and that was a little bit outside to Juan Teixeira. 1 out, single in the 4th. Sandwiched around 2 pop-ups. Low from Barnhouse, 2 balls and a strike. Tommy came in and surrendered an RBI single to Girardi and Ondina. Shocker scored the first run of the game in the 3rd. And then FIU struck for 3 in the 7th. Swing and a foul tip off of Cooper Harris. 2-2. John Bennett, the home plate umpire, walks out in front of home plate to give Cooper Harris some time to regroup if he needs it. Teixeira, Kennedy, and Figueroa, the due hitters. Hit in the air, left center field. Pretty well hit. Van Voren on the run, still going back, reaches up, and couldn't make the catch. It bounced out of his glove in deepest left center field. The ball just kept carrying on him, and Van Voren on his horse couldn't haul it in. So a leadoff double for Juan Teixeira. And now Kennedy, who starting last inning, hit a sinking liner to center field that Van Voren caught. So a big insurance run out there at second base. Kennedy's only plate appearance after replacing Justin Farmer came to start last inning. Here's a stretch by Barnhouse. Check the runner at second. The pitch, the bunt is on, and the pitch is high. Kennedy pulled the bat back and took ball one. Kennedy, so far this year, has not laid down a successful sacrifice. Cartaya has 3 of the 4 for FIU's team. The idea for Kennedy here is to bunt it hard enough to make Paxton Wallace come get it, third base. Runner at second, nobody out in the 8th inning. He squares, bunts back toward the mound, and to third base and way too late is Tommy Barnhouse. Wherever he got his advice, whether it was in his own head or from somebody else, it was not a wise decision. The only play there was to first base, and Kennedy reaches, and so does Teixeira at third, sliding in safely. So FIU back on the attack here in the 8th. A double and then a fielder's choice. It's ruled a single, but it's not. Either way, first and third, nobody out. Mike Pelfrey back out to the mound to have a visit with his entire infield. So pretty clear right now that Tommy Barnhouse needs a strikeout or a pop-up, need a non-productive out from Adrian Figueroa. Figueroa is 2 out of 3. Came into the game the third leading hitter on the team, the second leading hitter, I should say, at 313. He and Juan Teixeira are the only two guys hitting above 300 of the regulars. But he's had a good afternoon. Singled twice, scored once. Scored the tying run last inning. It's 3-2 FIU, but they are back and threatening here in the 8th. First and third, nobody out. Here's the first pitch to him, and it's high. 1 ball and no strikes. So Barnhouse has now surrendered four hits. And really, he's only given up three, but in the books, he's given up four hits. He needs a pop up in the worst way. Low and inside of the fastball, and it's 2-0. Both these bullpens are outside the field of play, beyond the barrier, and both are hard to see down into to check out who's getting ready for who. Barnhouse game for now, the 2-0. That's a strike, 2-1. Three to two, FIU. Teixeira at third. Kennedy at first. Swing and a miss, pitch down, 2-2. Figueroa may have helped out Barnhouse there. Cartilla would be next. Two balls, two strikes. Runners at the corners. A stretch by Barnhouse. Right-hander brings it home. And a little bit outside. Tried to backdoor Figueroa with a breaking ball. Now it's 3-2. Shockers and Stetson coming up in about an hour and a half. Or 2.5 hours, I should say. That one's pounded into the gap in right center field. Run's going to score. Here comes Kennedy around third. He's being waved in. He will score. Around second and stopping there is Figueroa. And it's now 5-2. So Figueroa hit one a ton to right center field, and that cleans him off. So now Barnhouse has given up two. And that's going to do it for Tommy Barnhouse, who did not have it today. Tommy will get credit for one-third of an inning. But five of the six guys that he faced got a hit. He only retired Sanchez on a fielder's choice to shortstop. And the damage is not done quite yet. There's a runner at second. Two runs home in the inning. New Shocker pitcher. We'll tell you about him in a minute. Capital Federal brings us a pitching change. Trust the True Blue team at Capital Federal for local home loans and banking services to keep you at the top of your game. Go to capfed.com. New Shocker Hurler will reveal when we come back.
We have many offices, and Capital Federal has many locations, so we can build those local relationships.
It's easy to get a hold of anybody at CapFed.
You need to look at what services they provide, what impact they have on the community, and who the people are, and CapFed checks the box on all three.
When you have a relationship with a bank that cares about the work that you're doing, then that makes it a really good relationship.
And I always recommend Capital Federal. They want the business, too, just like we do.
CapFed is business ready with business accounts and cash management services. Visit capfed.com/businessready. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Litton's Appliance would like to thank all their loyal customers for their support as we struggle through these tough times. If you are in need of a new appliance, Litton's will work hard, as always, to get you what you need at a price no more than the big box guys. If we don't have what you need in stock, we will help you out with a loaner when available to get you by until your order can be delivered. Come by, call, or visit our website today to make your selection from the many quality brands we sell like Whirlpool, Maytag, and KitchenAid. Litton's Appliance, where you'll always get the right product at the right price.
Sports Radio KFH.
J. McDonough takes over for Wichita State. Dockers a little bit of hot water now as FIU has caught fire in the seventh and now here in the eighth. McDonough will inherit a runner at second, no out situation with two runs home in the inning. Derek Cartaya with Figueroa at second base. FIU's gone double, single, double here in the eighth inning. Cartaya, one out of three. L.J. McDonough appearing for the fifth time this year. All out of the bullpen. No record, 4.91 ERA and 3 2/3. It was 1-0 going to the top of the seventh inning. Shockers hanging on to a one-run lead. FIU, as I mentioned, is caught fire. Bunt out in front of the plate, only throw to play to first, and McDonough threw it away. Safe at first. Backing up, though, was Jack Segrist at second. So over to third goes Cartaya, or Figueroa, I should say. And a throwing error on a sack bunt by the pitcher, L.J. McDonough. So 5-2, and work still to do for L.J. McDonough here in the eighth. Rosenblum being locked out so far, 0-3. And he takes high. One ball and no strikes. Figueroa at third, Cartaya at first. Two runs home in the inning. Swing and a miss by Rosenblum. Fastball from L.J. McDonough at 92. One ball and one strike. FIU trying to inch closer to 500. Again, their two-game day will come Sunday. Throw to first and runner back. Rosenblum is grounded to third, fly to center, fouled out to the catcher. FIU leading by three, looking for more. Pitch, a bunt to first base, a safety squeezes on, and Kosas couldn't decide what he wanted to do, and everybody was safe. He's going to come home, that would have been a bad decision, and by the time Rosenblum ran by him, it was too late. So Wichita State, while not committing physical errors, or maybe errors up on the board, have really not been very efficient here in the inning, and still nobody out. So a run scores. Cartaya to second. That's back-to-back three spots for FIU, and suddenly it's 6-2. So it'll be a sack bunt RBI. That's how they'll score that one. Runners at first and second. The bunt is in order again. Chavez pops it up back onto the roof. So double, single, double. Two bunts that Wichita State botched. One on a bad throw by L.J. McDonough. And one on basically indecision by Garrett Kosas. It was a safety squeeze that was pushed toward him. And as it turned out, the correct play would have been to tag Rosenblum coming by, but in his indecision to try to cut down the run at the plate, no outs recorded. Bunt, back to McDonough, looks a runner at third, throws to first instead, and that one's at least high enough for Kosas to take care of. Runners move up, though, and FIU has been out-fundamentaling Wichita State last couple of innings. So now Dante Girardi, and the Shockers will be forced to bring the infield in. Girardi dumped a RBI single against Tommy Barnhouse last inning. Shocker infielders, even with the baselines. Girardi takes a strike. In Wichita State's eight, they'll have 8-9-1 in the order. So now Tyler Myrick is really sitting pretty. Starting pitcher for FIU, he's got a four-run cushion. Girardi takes strike two. So now McDonough could use a strikeout of his own. No balls, two strikes, way ahead of Girardi in the count, who now calls timeout. Dante Girardi, freshman from Fort Lauderdale, son of Joe Girardi, former World Series champion. McDonough trying to get him. Keep this one 6-2. Here's a stretch in the pitch. Inside, moved him back, had him spinning out of the way of a slider that tried to front door him. One ball, two strikes. Here's a stretch, the pitch. Swung late and sliced foul down the right side. In between the berm and the hitting pavilion. Still 1-2 to Dante Girardi. McDonough leaning in for the sign. Now he straightens up. Comes set at the numbers. Comes to the plate with a 1-2. Swing and a miss. He struck him out. Girardi down on strikes. A big out number two. So two in scoring now position with two down two for Ondina. Ondina one out of four. RBI single in the seventh. FIU with three in the seventh and three here in the eighth. The infield will move back. But one more big one to get. A base hit here, and this is all but out of reach. Breaking ball in on him as Ondina shortened up as if the bunt. Ondina came into the game hitting 265, one out of four today. McDonough's pitch. Lined right side, peeling, and just fair. Just inside the line. Two more going to score. Ondina cruises into second base. He's not stopping there, and the throw to third is way offline. And Ondina would have been out with a good throw, but Segrist fired one up the left field line, and it's now 8-2 FIU. The Panthers have put on their hitting shoes in the last couple of innings. And now they have batted around here in inning number eight. Alex Sanchez is 0 for 4. So Ondina had his mind made up. He was going for three. He didn't even look at the third base coach or take a peek over his shoulder. And that one's fouled back to the net. It's nothing in one. So after being silenced through six innings by Preston Snavely, the FIU Panthers have awoken with three in the seventh, five in the eighth, 8-2 FIU. That one's a little bit low, slider that home plate umpire John Bennett decided not to ring up. It's 1-1. So now you really wonder if Tyler Myrick's going to come out for inning number eight. Lined in the center field, almost took McDonough's head off. That's 9-2. Sanchez with a bullet back through the middle. And now you're in a situation, if you're Wichita State and Eric Wedge, you might just leave McDonough out there, as harsh as that may be. This is their first of two games today and first of four in 3 days on the schedule for the weekend. Here's a stretch by McDonough, the pitch, and it catches the zone. Nine to two FIU all of a sudden. Swinging and a miss, the pitch down by Juan Teixeira. Teixeira started the inning with a double. He came home on Figueroa's double to the gap. So each pitcher now has surrendered three runs. Snavely, Barnhouse, and now McDonough. Upstairs and inside, two balls and a strike. Oh, Runner at first. Two outs, six home. And that's up and in. Five hits, a couple of bunts, actually three bunts. And the pitch, line drive, base hit, right field. That pitch was up, and now Teixeira has two hits in the inning. Sanchez stopped at second. Boy, FIU did not make a peep through the first six innings. They only had three hits. They have 11 hits in the last two innings. Five in the seventh. Six here in the eighth. Now Kennedy. He takes a strike. So L.J. McDonough, at the very least, is going to be asked to, for better or worse, get through the eighth inning. High fly ball, left center field, should be the inning. Van Voren under it and makes the catch, and the inning finally comes to a close. But FIU has a monster round. The Panthers score six, leave two, and our new score after 7.5, it's Panthers 9, Shockers 2.
Jordan Story, Vice President of Wichita Furniture and Mattress for Sendio.
Before we partnered with Sendio, it was a big stress on our company having HR and payroll all done internally. One of the biggest improvements that we've seen with employee communication is how fast Sendio gets to our employees. I would highly recommend partnering with Sendio as your HR partner. They make things so easy, and the communication between us and them has just helped us out immensely.
Call Sendio today, 316-630-9107.
Give your employees the smile power they need to conquer any business challenge with a healthy grin. When you want your top people to feel at the top of their game. When your sales team is fresh out of rebuttals and the deal needs to get closed. When it's time to pick a dental insurance plan, give your employees the nation's largest network of smile-defending dentists with plan options that meet your company's budget. Unleash your smile power with Delta Dental of Kansas.
97.5 and 1240, KFH, K248CY Wichita, KNSS HD2 Clearwater, a radio.com sports station.
So Tyler Myrick is indeed done after seven. Job well done for the FIU right-hander. He gave up six hits and a couple of runs in seven innings. Didn't walk anybody. And struck out, I believe, five. And so he exits with a 9-2 lead. So FIU with only six more outs to get to make Myrick a winner for the third time. Angel Tiburcio, new pitcher for FIU, 6'2 sophomore out of Wellington, Florida. He is appearing for the sixth time. He's 0-1 with a save and an ERA of 3. In his first nine innings this year, he struck out 12 and walked 8. So Angel Tiburcio will face Ross Cadena, who will hit for Harris 0-2. First pitch at the bottom of the eighth is high, one ball and no strikes. I mentioned earlier that part of the Achilles heel of this FIU baseball team through the first 14 games has been the base on balls. And that one's all the way back to the screen off the edge of the catcher Chavez's glove. It's two balls and no strikes. We mentioned coming in 14 games, they had averaged six bases on balls per game. Now, Myrick didn't walk anybody, and Myrick hasn't been the problem so far this year. He's had good command. But by and large, it's been the FIU bullpen that that has had a hard time finding home plate. That one's in there for a strike to Kadena. So Kadena hitting 263 on 10 out of 38. He likely will catch the second game coming up later on tonight against Stetson. That's wide, and it's three balls and a strike. And this is kind of that catch-22 for Mervell Melendez, their head coach. This is a perfect time to get some guys in there, get them some innings. But ball four and a leadoff walk to Ross Kadena is certainly not what Melendez had in mind. But that's what happened. That's what has happened more times than not when he's pointed down to the bullpen. So Tiburcio walks Kadena, hitting for Harris. And the Shockers need bunches of base runners, and there's a free one right there. Here's Van Vorn, who's had two infield singles. And he takes low, one ball and no strikes. 9-2 FIU, home half of the eighth. High in the air to right center field, a long run for Sanchez. He's over there, makes the call on the catch, looking up toward the sun. And he fires it back into the infield. So Van Voren is the first out of the eight. And now Segrist, one out of three. Drove in one of the two Shocker runs. Garrett Kosas with a towering home run to center the other. Again, Liam Eddy will pitch for Wichita State later on, about 2 hours and 15 minutes from now. Little looper towards shallow right field. It's going to drop for a base hit. Segrist has a couple of hits. Stopping at second is Kadena. So two on and one out. And now Andrew Stewart's going to hit for the first time. He came in to play shortstop a couple of innings ago. So he will hit in Elliott's spot, who was 0 for 3. Andrew Stewart is 2 for 18 at the plate. Takes high, one ball and no strikes. 9-2 FIU. Again, the story for the first six innings was Preston Snavely. High fly ball, foul territory. Long run for Girardi and everybody else, and it drops untouched in foul territory. But then in the last two innings, the story of the game has been the FIU offense. They have exploded against Snavely and two Shocker relievers for nine runs. Three in the seventh and six in the eighth. A ball and a strike to Andrew Stewart. A pair of base runners on there with one out. Ground ball foul, went down and golfed one. And now it's 1-2 to Stewart. We're in the bottom of the eighth, one out. Kadena walked, Segrist singled. And the 1-2 in the dirt, blocked by Chavez. And now it's 2-2 to Stewart. Two-two has popped up. Middle of the diamond. Infield fly rule is in effect. And squeezing it is Cartaya. Two away. Stewart pops out, and it'll bring up Paxton Wallace. Wallace one out of three so far today. One ball and no strikes to him. Nick Durgan will pitch tonight for Stetson against Liam Eddy. Again, 5:30 Central Time, the first pitch here from Melching Field, Conrad Park. strike in there. 1-1 to Shocker, third baseman. 9-2 FIU. Two on, two out in the bottom of the eighth. Wallace waves the bat, waiting. Here's the stretch. The pitch popped up behind home plate. Chavez didn't see it at first and now drops it. Well, to say he dropped it is probably a little unfair. He didn't locate it until the very last second and then got in the neighborhood and stuck the glove out, couldn't come up with it. Girardi, the third baseman, couldn't get there in time either. So Wallace should have been out number three, but he is hanging by a fingernail up there at one ball and two strikes. Chavez never really saw it until it was probably halfway down from its ascent. Here's a stretch. And the 1-2 to Wallace. Swing and a miss, a high fastball. He struck him out with 92 up around his shoulders. Shockers get two base runners, but nothing further. At the end of eight, it's FIU 9 and Shockers 2.
When Koch Industries seeks new talent for its workforce, it travels all of 2 miles from its global headquarters to Wichita State University. The team at Koch is filled with Shockers who are creating innovations to meet everyday needs like cleaner water, renewable fuels, advanced medical devices, safer vehicles, and energy-efficient building materials. See the inspiring stories for yourself at kochindustries.com.
Have you wanted to speak a new language but thought it would be too difficult? Then try Babbel. Babbel starts by teaching you words and phrases that gradually get more complex. Soon, you're practicing short conversations. So in 15 minutes a day, you'll be speaking a new language in a few weeks. Babbel is built around real life. It teaches you practical conversations that you will actually use. Babbel, language for life. Celebrating 10 million subscriptions sold. Now try Babbel for free. Just go to Babbel.com today. That's Babbel.com.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Sandra Means or John Green. In Mulvane, see Kirk Farber. And in Andover, see Wes Sawyer.
This is KFH.
Now pitching for Wichita State and making his 2021 debut, Christian Clack. Clack will pitch the ninth inning. It's 9-2 FIU. Clack, 6'4", lefty freshman. We'll be facing Figueroa, Cartaya, and Rosenblum here in the ninth. Ross Cadena now catching. So it'll be left-hander against left-hander. Adrian Figueroa has had hits in his last three plate appearances after striking out in his first attempt against Preston Snavely. It was 1-0 after 6.5. Or after 6, I should say. It is now 9-2. Clack to Figueroa. Strike call. 0-1. So Snavely 6 2/3, 6 hits, 3 runs. Tommy Barnhouse, 1/3 inning, 5 hits and 3 runs. 0-1, swung very late and chopped over the third base coach's head. It's 0-2. LJ McDonough went 1, gave up 3 hits. There was at least one error mixed in there in that 6-run 8th inning, so the 3 runs that he gave up were unearned. And now Christian Clack, 0-2, up over his head and back to the screen. Figueroa kind of glanced out at Christian Clack. But this is Clack's debut. There was no intent in a 9-2 runaway. 1-2, nobody on, nobody out in the FIU ninth. Clack can't get together with Ross Cadena, now steps off. Clack working out of the stretch with nobody on. Here's the stretch. 0-2, or 1-2 rather, chopped foul. Oddly, no Wichita State pitcher has issued a walk today. But after being silenced on 3 hits through 6 innings, 11 in the seventh and eighth combined. Swing and a miss. Down goes Figueroa. Christian Clack strikes out the first man he faces as a college pitcher. Here's Derek Cartaya, the little second baseman. He was the first man to greet L.J. McDonough last inning. So one out, base is empty in the top of the ninth. FIU three outs away from getting to 7-8 on the year. Upstairs to Cartaya, one ball and no strikes. Shockers will fall to 7-6, barring a miracle comeback. That one's very high. It's 2-0 to Cartaya. So Wichita State will switch dugouts. They will go from the third base side to the first base side, presumably. They'll be a visiting team. I don't know if necessarily Stetson usually resides in the third base dugout or not, but Shockers will be the visiting team against Stetson in the nightcap. It's 3-0 to Cartaya, and high ball four. So after a strikeout, a four-pitch walk to the 5-5 Derek Cartaya.
Stepping up to the plate, number 10, the DH, Ben Rosenblum.
Here's Rosenblum. Rosenblum has been hitless so far, but he was part of that six-run eighth inning. He laid down a bunt and reached and knocked in a run. It was a safety squeeze, swinging a foul back. No balls and a strike facing Christian Clack. Rosenblum, 0 for 3, though, has knocked in one and scored one. Outside, and it's one ball and one strike. So now everybody in the FIU lineup has reached base safely at least once. One pitch, cut on and missed. A ball and two strikes to Ben Rosenblum, a freshman. Again, an interesting lineup. They have four freshmen and three seniors in their starting nine. Clack's 1-2 pitch, jammed him, a little fly ball foul down the right side into the berm. And John Bennett wants a new supply of baseballs. Stay tuned after the game for the post-game show. We will have the final stats, game recap, play and player of the game, and a quick look at the scoreboard, although if this game finishes somewhat quickly, there won't be much going on in the American. And that's into the dirt, all the way back to the screen, clangs off a pole, a wild pitch. We'll send Cartaya down to second base. So two balls and two strikes. And here on KFH, after the game, we will have the drive with Bob and Jeff. That'll take us up to 5:30 Central Time for the first pitch of Wichita State and Stetson. So pitch it back to the drive, and then back here at 5:30 for game two between Wichita State and Stetson. Over but low, and it's three balls and two strikes to Rosenblum. 9-2 FIU, we're in the top of the ninth. Runner at second, one out. Christian Clack trying to make his way through the ninth inning here. Started with a strikeout, then a walk. Wild pitch, out of the 3-2. Hit on the ground, sharply and into left field, past Paxton Wallace. Stopping at third will be Cartaya. And Rosenblum has his first hit. That is hit number 15 now.
Now batting number 9, the catcher, Luis Chavez.
Now Luis Chavez He's two for three, single double. Runners at the corners, one away. Kristen Clack making his Shocker debut. Cartaya away at third, Rosenblum at first, Kosas holding him on. Down and in, one ball and no strikes. And an unenviable task to be in the shoes of Christian Clack. He's probably nervous. The game's out the gate, and he's dealing with a lot of stuff out there. Every newcomer does in his debut. And there's no real ideal time to work him out there. That one's down and in, and Clack is starting to struggle. Two balls and no strikes. And with it being a runaway in the wrong way for Wichita State, you got a lot of comfortable hitters up there for FIU. Two balls and no strikes. And that's a little too high, 3-0. So Clack just tried to ease one in there at the top of the zone. And it's now 3-0. And certainly the last thing that Mike Pelfrey or Eric Wedge wants in the Wichita State dugout is to pull Christian Clack here in the ninth. And that was inside. I think it hit Chavez's armor on his front elbow. Either way, it would have been a ball four. So a hit batter, and now they're loaded up. And Mike Pelfrey is going to make a trip to the mound. So Christian Clack, after striking out Figueroa to start the inning, has fallen on hard times. They are loaded with one away for Dante Girardi. Again, the game times for Wichita State from here on out, 5:30 Central time tonight, 5:30 Central tomorrow, and then 10:30 a.m. the Central time zone for the first pitch of the final game of the weekend. That game time has been adjusted since the schedule was announced. But Wichita State on getaway day will play 11:30 here local time, 10:30 back in the Central time zone, just to make sure that the Shockers get out of here in good shape on Sunday. So here's Girardi with the bases drunk. One out. Top of the ninth, 9-2 FIU. Girardi, one out of four. Had an RBI single in that three-run seventh. Cartaya, Rosenblum, and Chavez, the base runners. First pitch to Dante Girardi is upstairs. One ball and no strikes. The flip side of the you don't want to have to pull Christian Clack conversation is you don't want to leave him out there to die either. Swing and a foul back to the screen. It's pretty delicate and fine line to walk, your coaching staff. It's 9-2. Shockers down to their final three outs and one more game to play tonight and three more altogether. You don't want to burn through the bullpen trying to get through a 9-2 game. Down and in, and Kadena kept it near him as best he could. Just trying to nurse Christian Clack through this ninth inning. It was 1-0 Shockers after three. It's 3-1 after 6.5. Kosas hit a home run for Wichita State to make it 3-2 after seven. But a sixth spot in the top of the eighth blew it open for FIU. They're threatening for more here. Upstairs, and it's 3-1, and I think Christian Clack might be down to his last pitch. Can't find the strike zone. Only one out in the inning, so he is starving for a double play ball here. Get him through his first inning as a Shocker unscathed. Girardi ahead in the count, 3-1. The pitch to him, high ball four. And Christian Clack has walked in a run. So two walks, a hit batter, and a single. And that'll officially be Girardi's second run batted in of the day.
Now batting the shortstop, number two, Steven Ondina.
Now the top of the order and Steven Ondina. Clack's going to get at least one more batter here, or maybe just another couple pitches. We'll see. So everybody moved up 90 feet. First pitch is down and in. Missed badly. One ball and no strikes. And this is painful for all involved in the Shocker dugout and on the field. It's 10-2 FIU. Ondina has knocked in three in his last two plate appearances. And he takes way low and inside. Two balls and no strikes. Only one hit in the inning. It was Rosenblum's single to the left of Paxton Wallace. High ball three. So if Ondina reaches, Sanchez would be next. FIU sent 11 to the plate last inning, scoring six. Put this one out of reach. And that's way high, ball four. Another base on balls from Christian Clack. And it's now 11-2.
Now batting for the Panthers, number four, center fielder, Alec Sanchez.
Now Sanchez and Ross Cadena is going to go out to the mound to try to encourage Christian Clack. This is a tough, tough situation for the Shocker left-hander on the mound right now. Still just one out in the inning, too. So even if he gets a strikeout or a pop-up, he's got one more out to get. So he's facing Alex Sanchez. And maybe the saving grace here, if you're looking for a silver lining, is Sanchez is a left-hand batter, and Clack struck out the first one that he faced in the inning in Figueroa. So Clack from the stretch delivers. There's a strike. Nothing in one to Alex Sanchez. Sanchez RBI single his last time up there. If you were listening early and departed and came back late, you missed a lot. Line drive, ground ball to the second baseman. Might be 2-4-6 and safe at first. Andrew Stewart couldn't get the ball out of his glove. And now they're going to call runner's interference. It's a double play as Ondina went barreling into Andrew Stewart. So it'll be a double play, and the inning is over. So a 4-6-3 double play, and the inning does come to an end, and the Shockers are down to their final three outs. So two runs in the inning. And now Wichita State with its last chance coming to bat in the bottom of the ninth.
AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, 13th and Greenwich Road in Wichita, is your new home for Shocker Coaches shows. Be sure to check out our all-new burger menu because Mondays are burger days at AJ's. And don't forget, Thursdays are buy one, get one free pizza day. Dine in only and excludes the Superdome. Join us for happy hour every day from 2 to 6 p.m. and 9 to 11 p.m. While you're here, ride the go-karts, take a turn in the laser maze, enjoy the game room, or bowl a couple games. AJ's Sports Grill at the Alley, home of the Superdome 29-inch pizza. Two locations in Wichita and one in Hutchinson. Proud supporter of Shocker Athletics.
If I'm not commuting anymore, where do I really want to live?
While you handle life's questions, Merrill Guided Investing helps you manage your portfolio and invest for your next move with the option to work with an advisor at a low cost and minimum. Merrill, a Bank of America company. Visit merrilledge.com/investinggoals to get started today.
Investing involves risk. Merrill Lynch, Pierce Fenner, and Smith Incorporated, both a registered broker-dealer and investment advisor, member SIPC. Investment products are not FDIC insured or not bank guaranteed and may lose value.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Michael Rogers or Dusty Self. In Augusta, see Dylan Hartnett. And in Valley Center, see Tim Dink.
Sports Radio KFH.
Will Saxton will try to get the final three outs for FIU. The Panther lefty will face Kosas, Bartlett, and Kornblum in the Shocker ninth inning. It's 11-2. FIU, they've scored a bushel of runs in the last three innings. So Saxton will appear for the sixth time. He's 1-0 with an ERA of 9.95. Six and a third, 11 hits, 9 walks, 10 strikeouts. So we'll see if there's a parade of Shocker pinch hitters here in the bottom of the ninth. The short answer to that is yes. Cade Clemens will hit for Kosas. So Christian Clack, in that previous half inning, got a double play to end the inning technically. He went one inning, gave up one hit, two runs, three walks, and a strikeout. And he also hit a batter. So here's Cade Clemens trying to get his first hit of the season facing left-hander Will Saxton. Saxton from the stretch with nobody on, swing and a miss by Clemens. Seth Stroh has grabbed a bat, and he figures to hit for Corrigan Bartlett, whose 12-game winning streak is going to come to an end unless the Shockers score nine here. Popped up, foul, back and out of play. It's nothing and two. Again, here in just a little bit, the post-game show, and following that right here on KFH is The Drive with Bob and Jeff. They will take us up to 5:30 Central Time and hand it back to Melching Field here on the campus of Stetson University. Chopper foul at the feet of Cade Clemens. Garrett Kosas went one out of three. He had a towering long home run to center, his eighth of the year back in the seventh. That made it 3-2. We were 3-2 after seven. 1-0 after six, 3-2 after seven. But the next eight runs have been scored by FIU. Strike three called on the inside corner. Got Cade Clemens looking.
Now batting number 23, Seth Stroh.
So now Seth Stroh is going to hit for Bartlett, who was 0-for-1 with two walks. Stroh, 4 out of 20. Takes one right in there, nothing in one. Base is empty, one out, bottom of the ninth. It's 11-2, FIU. Pours one in there, does Saxton, and it's 0-2. Chuck Ingram is going to hit for Cooper Kornblum. No balls and two strikes to Seth Stroh. Saxton delivers. Foul ball. No balls and two strikes. One out in the Shocker ninth. Stroh against 6'4 lefty Will Saxton. Here's a stretch. And again, the 0-2 pitch. A little outside. Luis Chavez liked it, though. Gave an attaboy signal to his lefty Will Saxton. One ball and two strikes. Stroh up there from the left side, waiting the pitch. Had him reaching a looper into shallow right center field and calling off the right fielder is Alex Sanchez, the center fielder, as Kennedy peeled off out of the way. So Stroh kind of one-armed one that actually carried a good amount to right center, but out now number two. And
nine,
last chance of the game for Wichita State, it's Chuck Ingram. Ingram, 4 out of 19. All four of his hits this year have been for extra bases. Saxton's first pitch to him is low and outside. And it's one ball and no strikes. So Chuck Ingram hitting 211. Getting a plate appearance here in the ninth. Three consecutive pinch hitters with FIU leading 11-2. Towering fly ball to left center. This should do it. And Sanchez makes the call on the catch. And that's that. So Wichita State goes down in order in the ninth. Shockers had a 1-0 lead after six, but it was all FIU after that. 11-2 the final. We'll be right back.
This broadcast has been an exclusive presentation of the Shocker Sports Properties Radio Network. Executive producer is Mark Rogers. For information about this broadcast, contact Shocker Sports Properties. Coverage of the Wichita State Shockers is authorized by Shocker Sports Properties and is intended...
Good call, Shane. That's what I'm thinking.
All right.
Rebroadcast, internet streaming, or other use of the accounts and descriptions of this game without written consent on Shocker Sports Properties, Playfly Sports, or the University is prohibited. The Shocker Sports Properties Radio Network is a division of Shocker Sports Properties and Playfly Sports.
Litton's Appliance would like to thank all their loyal customers for their support as we struggle through these tough times. If you are in need of a new appliance, Litton's will work hard, as always, to get you what you need at a price no more than the big box guys. If we don't have what you need in stock, we will help you out with a loaner when available to get you by until your order can be delivered. Come by, call, or visit our website today to make your selection from the many quality brands we sell like Whirlpool, Maytag, and KitchenAid. Litton's Appliance, where you'll always get the right product at the right price.
It's time to go inside the numbers with BKD, CPAs, and advisors. BKD has proudly served the Midwest for more than 90 years. Your team values excellence as much as ours, and we're your biggest fans. As you look toward continued growth and profitability, BKD has the bench strength and resources to help you develop a winning strategy. Everyone needs a trusted advisor. Who's yours? Go to BKD.com and go Shocks!
No matter what pops up during your day, Ascension Via Christi, the exclusive healthcare provider of Shocker Athletics, makes it easy to get the care you need at any time from anywhere. Now you can see a doctor online, right from home, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Check in online for immediate care. Find ER care near you, or you can even schedule a visit with a primary care doctor. You'll find it all at GetViaChristiCare.com. That's GetViaChristiCare.com.
Oh, Mr. Corn Blue, what are you looking for, buried treasure?
Switch to T-Mobile for Business and get up to 90 days.
Let's pee down his air hole.
Hey.
And you get a great deal, the largest 5G network, and first-class benefits like Microsoft...
Dave's going to voice track, Shane.
Uh-huh.
And Bob's very impatient. He wants sound. I go, he can't. Shane's on the comrack. Grumble, grumble.
Express MasterCard within 8 weeks of receipt of valid submission. Complete port within 60 days. See T-Mobile.com for 5G devices, coverage, and plan details.
Shocker Sports is brought to you by American Family Insurance. In Wichita, see Vivian Adams, Sean Chapman, Kerry Mock, or Chris Post. In El Dorado, see Becky Shum.
This is KFH.
Back here at Melching Field in DeLand, Shane Dennis with you here on the campus of Stetson University. It was a pitching duel for two-thirds of the game. 1-0, Wichita State heading into the top of the seventh inning, as Preston Snavely was making a third inning RBI single by Jack Seagrass stand up. But Snavely started leaking a little oil in the seventh. He was charged with 3 runs. It was 3-1 after 6.5. Then Garrett Kosas hit a home run in the bottom of the seventh to make it 3-2. But the next 8 runs were scored by FIU in a 6-run eighth inning that knocked out Wichita State. And Panthers added on 2 more. In the ninth. 11-2 is the final. And that's your game recap brought to you by Bill and Nika Cummings. Cummings and Cummings, your criminal defense and DUI law firm in Wichita. Give them a call at 316-264-1548 or visit them online at BillCummingsLLC.com. Cummings and Cummings Law, where your needs always come first. Our player of the game is a presentation of Kansas Star Casino. David Van Voren is our Shocker player of the game. He had 2 base hits, a couple of stolen bases, scored 1 of the 2 Shocker runs. So David Van Voren is our Kansas Star Casino player of the game. And no other scores to tell you about. Nobody starting, or there's only one other game actually in the American that had started, man, now make it two. Southern Illinois, or I'm sorry, in the in Conference USA, Southern Illinois leading Marshall 2-0, and UAB and Indiana State in Conference USA, besides FIU winning this one. In the American Conference, there was one scheduled game to start. Yeah, Xavier leading 2-0 over Cincinnati in the top of the third. And just getting underway in a little bit will be Middle Tennessee and Memphis. So the nightcap of this day-night doubleheader will have more of the scores for you. State Farm brought to you, brings you your scoreboard update. Protect your car and home with State Farm, here to help life go right. Talk to an agent today at 1-800-STATE-FARM. 11-2 the final. FIU wins it. We will go inside the numbers and have our play of the game and wrap it up from Melting Field after this.
Wake up, comb your hair, grab your keys, go to work, clock in, clock out, sit in traffic, get home, TV on, grab a beer, roll a joint, take a sip, take a hit, relax. Hungry? Barbecue sounds good. Delivery? Nah, you're good to drive. Get in the car, get on the road, run the red. Never saw the other car.
DUIs, jail time, death. These can and will happen if you drive impaired. Brought to you by the Kansas Department of Transportation and your Kansas law enforcement community.
Hey, Shocker fans! Ready for a new and exciting golf membership? Join the club where Shocker fans and staff play. When you join Great Life, you have two beautiful golf courses to choose from: Tallgrass Country Club and Willow Bend Golf Club. Experience our warm and inviting country club atmosphere. Perfect your skills at our excellent practice facilities, all included with that one membership. Enjoy the best golfing value in Wichita at one of our courses and spend more time on the fairway with Great.